Let's talk about Arrow season 5 then. I haven't been watching Arrow for a while now. Ever since Diggle put his helmet on, I was like, no more, thank you. I don't know. I don't really give a shit about this trailer, but someone who has seen it, please talk about it.
I don't like that it starts. Basically, the first bit of dialogue in it starts with Felicity says, and it just seems to be carrying on exactly where it left off, and the fans aren't going to like it. And honestly, from the first impressions, Arrow won't make it out of season 5. This will be it, the last season of Arrow.
Interesting.
It's trying to set up something new. It's got to get a new team, and that's quite exciting because the old team was dead. Diggle putting on that daft helmet, Laurel being 6 feet under, Sarah being messing around in a spaceship. Speedy's still there, but she's, I mean, it's not quite clear what's going to happen with her. She's, as far as I'm concerned, that she's Thea's the best character in the show at the
That is
moment.
surprising to me, but go on.
Honestly, it is that bad. Arsenal was brilliant. Got rid of him because how dare somebody take the limelight away from somebody else. But it looks there's promise there, but it does seem like it's continuing to pander.
So Roy
And if
isn't in it
that,
anymore.
no, he disappeared. He went off. He got Mirakuru'd up,
Yeah, I remember that
and it
bit.
killed a copper. Couldn't deal with it. And went off and disappeared off. Couldn't basically couldn't just couldn't handle it. So he went off to become a mechanic somewhere, but people found him. So there was sort of a tease last season that he might be coming back, or he might be going off to be Arsenal somewhere else, which was quite exciting. And he did show up in one episode, and then disappeared again,
Right.
which would have been to keep him around would have been a nice, strangely enough, fresh take, bringing an old character back, making something fresh, but. It would have been good. He was a solid character. And I am genuinely fearful the fact that this seems to be Felicity's team now rather than Oliver's team. And then you've got Mr. Not Fantastic. What's his name? Mr. Somebody. I don't know what his name is. Who's showing
Terrific.
up? Mr.
Yes.
Terrific. That's the one. Mr. Terrific's been set up this season. But I'm not a huge fan of the actor anymore after the way he was
Oh,
responding to fans.
Jesus Christ, that was a shitstorm.
It's just, I don't understand what's going on. It's like
Yeah,
Mark Guggenheim's completely lost control of the show. And
it's
you've got actors.
a dick.
Actors.
You too.
Yeah. It's just like you can't just go
You
around
can't.
telling your fans to go and eat a dick. For God's sake, you're playing a gay character. In a cult show, you can't do that. It's just, it is like the showrunners have completely lost control of what's going on. The inmates have taken over the asylum,
Yeah.
and it doesn't look like it's gonna. It looks like it's gonna be entertaining. Looks like there might be some good amusement going on as they're training up the new team, and a couple of interests. I mean, there's a couple of characters who they're bringing into it who we've already seen in one-off shots. And they were always promising. So they're going to be part of the main team, but I just don't think they're going to be enough to bring it back.
Put it this way, I'm glad John Barrowman now has a CW contract rather than an Arrow contract.
Yeah.
Because I love Merlin, genuinely like it when he appears, and if Arrow's going down, he's not going down with it.
Yeah. It's a shame because the show was so good, but again, you
Season
can't
two is some of
open.
the best TV.
I watched the trailer today, and when just as soon as he said Felicity said this, well, I could hear the internet screaming in pain as that happened. There's just fans everywhere turning off their screens. They can't face another season of being told that Felicity is more Team Arrow than Oliver Queen is. And
Well,
I struggle. See, I struggle to stop something halfway through. I do. I will finish most. I finished Lost. I'm still
rip.
watching Bones,
Oh,
so I
mate.
struggle to turn series off.
I don't.
And I'm gonna give this a couple of episodes in, and even I'm at the line there where I'm just thinking I can't do it to myself.
I'm
It gets me
watching the
so
first
angry.
episode. Watching the first episode, and then I'll decide whether like that makes or break it. Arrow season 3 lost me. Season 4 just...
I was horrendous. Season 1 and 2 were absolutely so perfect television.
They were fallen so far from grace. So I'll give it one more chance. Like, and that's mainly just because I want to see how things tie into the universe at this point. CW have got a great lineup of shows.
Yeah, what do you want to do? Bring
Constantine back. Replace Arrow with Constantine, I'll be happy.
Yeah, that's been shut down as well by the Constantine creators. There was talk of that he was going to be coming back, and it's gone again. The general consensus now is Matt Ryan's always open to it.
I hope he gets a CW contract. If he gets one of them, I'll be so happy.
Constantine will never run on CW.
I know.
It's not a CW show.
But Matt Ryan's a hot, attractive guy.
I mean, what they've done is they've turned Arrow into a CW show. Because it wasn't. Mm. Season 1 and 2 weren't CW programs. And then they've turned it into one. The will they, won't they, kiss and cuddle program. Which is fine for Supergirl, because Supergirl's bright and it's airy and there's lots of colour. Arrow is dark, it's grimy, and people should be dying. And they're not. They're just getting clubbed over the head with a polycarbonate bow.
Getting shot up in a limo and then surviving. And then walking.
Magically walking because of some amazing technology.
Triggered.
So it's turned into a rant. It could be amazing. It probably isn't going to be. And there you go. That's Arrow trailer.
All right, agreed.
Stephen Amell, you're always welcome on the show.
He's a lovely guy. I'll give him that.
No, Stephen Amell is amazing.
He tries his best, doesn't he? He's trying so hard. But again, if you even look at his social media presence is quite high. You look at him during season 1 and 2, every week, this is the best episode we ever shot. This is amazing. You should all go and watch it now. Season 4, nothing whatsoever. Not one.
The best
thing
about season 4, I think it was, or was it season 3, where it was like when he was hyping up a wrestling match.
The only thing about this that is interesting to me is they are within a stone's throw of episode 100, and I think they've said that that's the big crossover episode.
That'd be cool.
That could be something quite special, even if the rest of the season is trash. So as a show, we'll probably watch episode 1 so we can talk about whether it's good or not, and we'll maybe have to come back for the big anniversary episode as well. But
Like season 4 did it, like not all of it was dreadful. Like there were some good high points in it. Laurel's last episode.
No, I mean I'd love to watch Laurel die over and over again, to be honest, but
honestly, Laurel and Thea with the
be
two
quiet,
saving
Alex.
Graces.
I'm not gonna hear this from you. No.
No, they were the saving graces.
No.
Laurel was exceptional in season 4.
Felicity gets shut up. Okay?
Yeah, I can't agree with that.